So you're working on a team project in your engineering class, huh? Well, let's talk about why teaming is important in engineering design and how you can develop a successful plan, with your team of course, to encourage innovation and risk-taking. Today, we're talking about psychological safety in engineering teams. Engineering organizations around the world are becoming increasingly team-based because they believe that teams are able to generate solutions to complex problems more effectively than individuals alone, due to a team's wider range of knowledge and expertise. In other words, the wisdom of the collective can help a team perform above and beyond the sum of its individual members. This is important because companies must continually implement new ideas in order to survive and thrive in fast-growing markets that demand continuous product innovations. Because of the importance of teams in design outputs, companies have long since tried to figure out how to build the best team. One of these companies that has invested a significant amount of resources into this is no other than Google. In a project coined Project Aristotle, Google spent time studying hundreds of its own teams to try and figure out why some succeeded and some failed. Did it matter more whether everyone was motivated by the same kinds of rewards? How often the teammates socialized outside of the office? Did that impact team performance? Or perhaps team performance was impacted by those who had the same hobbies? What they found was surprising. The who part of the equation didn't seem to matter. Google's data indicated that psychological safety, more than anything else, was critical to making a team work. Psychological safety is a shared belief that a team is safe for interpersonal risk-taking. So, why is this important in engineering? Well, researchers have shown that teams with high levels of psychological safety have better information sharing, they have higher levels of learning and creativity, and ultimately they're more satisfied with their work. So, why is psychological safety important in engineering teams? Well, if a team isn't psychologically safe, then team members may hold back from sharing ideas, asking for help, and admitting mistakes. When they hold back, groups and organizations are at risk for business failures and safety failures. Why? Well, we live in a VUCA world that is volatile, unpredictable, complex, and ambiguous. So, today's problems cannot be solved by one person, one discipline, one industry, or one country. Work today requires collaborations across the boundaries. We also live in a knowledge economy, where individuals' ideas add value. But valuable ideas worth paying attention to won't get said if team members do not feel comfortable enough to speak up. When members hold back, team members do not learn from each other, and creativity can be stifled. When your team lacks psychological safety, you'll never know who had a great idea but did not share it with your team, who needed help but didn't ask for assistance, or who made a mistake but instead of asking for help, covered it up. When team members don't feel psychologically safe in their team environment, they won't speak candidly, ask questions, voice concerns, or admit mistakes, because no one wants to be perceived as ignorant, so they don't ask questions. No one wants to be perceived as incompetent, so they don't admit weaknesses or mistakes. No one wants to seem like they're interfering, so they don't offer ideas that they're unsure about. And finally, we don't want to seem critical, so we don't offer evaluative comments. So, if we know psychological safety is an imperative part of teaming, what can we do to foster psychological safety in our own teams? Well, we've developed three stages that can help you foster psychological safety in your engineering team. The first building block focuses on setting the stage. Then we want to invite engagement and respond appreciatively. When we set the stage, we want to make sure that we frame the work appropriately. We want to characterize the word as VUCA, volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous, so no one person has all the answers. Member participation is essential to success. We also want to make sure that our members are acknowledging their own fallibility and limits. We've never solved this problem before, so we're all learning this together. No one person has all of the answers. And finally, we want to make sure that we're modeling inclusivity in our teams. I may miss something. I don't have all the answers. I'm not an expert in this. And diversity is the key to success. So once you've set the stage, you need to make sure that you invite engagement. You want to be proactive in your invitation of input. Ask questions like, we need to hear from you. Your voice may make the difference. Or, we need your brain in the game. We also want to make sure that we're inviting divergent, outside-of-the-box thinking by asking key questions like, what are we missing here? Who has a different perspective on this problem? Or, let's play devil's advocate for a moment. Finally, we want to make sure that we're inviting deeper levels of thinking by asking questions like, unpack that for me. Tell me more. Can you give us an example? What would happen if we did? Was everything as good as it could have been? You want to make sure you're creating a space for input in meetings and asking plenty of good questions. Finally, you want to make sure that once you've created an environment where people are comfortable contributing, that you respond appreciatively. You want to recognize that even if you set the stage and invite engagement, psychological safety may be damaged if you don't respond productively. So, how do we respond productively? Well, you want to make sure that you're showing genuine interest in comments, that you're listening to, understand, and not just to respond, that you're affirming every member's comments in some way, and that you're not humiliating members for admitting mistakes. Rather, you're there to help them get back on track because you're a team after all. Building psychological safety is not a one-time thing. It's something your team must continue to work on. Much like the design process, it's a cyclic process that requires constant attention. I hope you've learned what psychological safety is, the building blocks to fostering it in your team, why it's important. Now, go change the world and foster psychological safety in your own teams. Thank you.